towards the children. And last videos we have seen about the concept of rational and irrational numbers, and I have completed exercise 1C. Today I am going to explain in exercise 1D the new concept I am going to introduce today, that is nothing, it is sure. What is the meaning of sure? Just look at the definition there I have given here. Let A be a rational number and a positive integer n such that nth root of A is called irrational. Then that nth root of A is called as sure. So irrational root of A positive rational number is called as sure. So inside I have given there a notation nth root of A, right? So inside the A must be rational number, and the whole nth root of A, it should be an irrational. Then only we can call that number as a sure number. So here we want to see two important note. That first note is nth root of A is sure, no? Surely inside the rational, A is an irrational number, and nth root of A, it is irrational. That is first point. And the second point, when it is not assured, so what are all the numbers I can say it is not assured, which means inside that nth root of A, that is irrational, it is not assured. Okay, so very important note, you have to look at that inside that value A must be rational, and nth root of A, it is irrational. So these two things, it must be satisfied, that number only we can call it assured, otherwise it is not a assured number. Okay, and now okay, I'll let me show some few examples related to this. See, look at this example. Now the first one we have here, root 3 and cubic root of 4 and fourth root of 6 and seventh root of 10. So these numbers are sure numbers. How we can say? Just look at root 3. We all know that already, we have seen that explanation. It is irrational number, so we can sure it is sure. But just look at the second number. It is cubic root of 4. Cubic root of 4, inside 4, how do you write 2 into 2? And 2 into 2, it is a perfect square. If it is a square root, we can say it is not assured, but it is a cubic root. Cubic root means we want to write the factor, 3 numbers as one factor. We can take it out from cubic root. But here we have only the 2 factor, 2 into 2. It is only 2 numbers only we have a factor. So we cannot take it out from the cubic root. So which means it is not a, it is not, it, the whole number, it is an irrational. It is not a rational. The whole, it is not rational. The whole root, it is irrational root. So if it is irrational root, obviously the number, it is assured number. So when we can say it is not assured, I told you that if you have inside the root that A value is rational, if it is irrational, then we can say it is not assured. Just look at your second example I have given here. It is root pi. Yes, root pi is not assured. Why I am saying it is not assured? Now already we know that pi is a irrational number. Already we have seen the proof also, right? So if you have inside that radicand value is irrational, definitely that root, it is not assured. Okay, so these points you have to remember. So look at the number, the whole root, it is irrational root, only you can say it is assured, otherwise it is not assured. And one more example I can show you. See, look at this number I have given here. It is cubic root of 27. Cubic root of 27, how do you split the number 27? 3 into 3 into 3. 3 threes are 9, 9 threes are 27. Okay, exactly, we have 3 factor. Now among all these 3 factor, according to the cubic root, we can take one number outside. If you have taken out, you can get the answer is 3. So which means that value is 3. So it is not a the answer is rational, it is not an irrational number, right? So this root, it is not an irrational root, so it is not a assured number. Okay, so perfect square and perfect cubes are not assured. So only two things you have to remember, that inside the radicand must be assured, and inside the rat must be rational, and the whole nth root of A, it is irrational. And second thing I want to tell you in short concept, that is rationalizing factor. What is the meaning of rationalizing factor? Rationalizing factor in the sense, before that I want to tell you when I can introduce this rationalizing factor, when I want to apply this rationalizing factor to solve the problem. Just look at that given number, the denominator, it is in the form of irrational number. I said denominator. Denominator, it is in the form of irrational. You have to make it as rational. That time only we have to use this rationalizing factor, introducing this rationalizing factor to multiply both numerator and denominator. Then the denominator, it becomes a perfect square number. So it becomes a rational form. So rational factor, it is nothing but to rationalizing the shared number. That is what here I am saying about the rationalized factor. Okay, so RF, it's otherwise it's called as conjugate. Remember the term. So how to apply and how to find the RF in the given problem, and how to apply and how to solve, let's see next, followed by I will explain in the problem. Okay, so this is your first problem I am going to explain. Multiply. So here the question is 1 by root 2, right? So first what I told you, that we want to take the rationalizing factor. Rationalizing factor, what I said, that it is nothing but what the denominator it is given, that opposite number we can consider. But here if the denominator is sum of the number or difference of the number, if you have two terms, now we can take the opposite sign. But here it is not like that. Your first problem I have chosen as a simple one. The denominator we have only one number. If you have the denominator is only one number, you can consider that rationalizing factor as the same number. So RF is nothing but here the same denominator. What the number is given, the same number, you can take it as the RF. Okay, so 1 by root 2, root 2 is the denominator. So the same number I have considered as the rationalizing factor. So what is the next step? I told you that we want to multiply the RF to the numerator as well as to the denominator. So that's why here they have multiplied to the numerator also the RF, and denominator also they have multiplied that root 2. After you have written this step, you have to multiply that number in into here, that numerator and the denominators. So 1 into root 2 is nothing but root 2, and the denominator is root 2 into root 2. So what is that root 2 into root 2? Root 2 into root 2, it is nothing but, already I told you that root 2 into root 2 can be written as root of 2 into 2. According to the square root concept, we can take one number outside, so the answer is 2. That's why they have written the denominator as 2. So this is the way we have to solve the simple problem. If the denominator, if you have a single number, okay, the two number in the sense, we can take the opposite sign. If it is single number, no problem, you can consider the same number as the RF. Now let's see next problem. Here the question is 5 by root 2. So look at the denominator. What is the denominator here? It is root 2. Right, so root 2 in the sense, what I told you, you can consider the RF is the same number. So root 2 itself you can consider as RF. Now you have to multiply the number with the numerator as well as in the denominator. Then you have to multiply that numerators, both numerator and both denominators, these two numbers we want to multiply. So 5 into root 2, it is 5 root 2, and root 2 into root 2, root 2 into root 2, again it is what, root 2 into root 2, they have written here as root 4. After that they have taken out root 4 is the perfect square, so we have taken out, it is 2. So 5 root 2 divided by 2, right? So I'll give you one more problem. Look at here, 2 divided by 2a root 5. So what is the number here in the denominator? Actually what I told you, that if you have one number, you can consider RF as the same. RF, nearby RF we have the coefficient 2a. No need to bother about that coefficient. Simply you consider RF as the root number itself. No need to take the whole denominator as the RF. Only you take RF is root 5. Just ignore the remaining coefficients, whatever it is there, if it is single term. Okay, so I have ignored 2a and I consider only this root 5 as the RF, and I have multiplied in the numerator and the denominator, and then I want to multiply these two numbers in numerator, these two numbers in the denominator. So root 2 into root 5, it's nothing but 2 root 5, and down denominator you see that root 2a right as such is, and then I have multiplied root 5 into root 5, again root 5 into root 5, it is 25. 25 is the perfect square. So perfect square, na 5 into 5, we can take, according to the square root concept, 1 5 we can taken out. That's why they have written here 5. Now we want to multiply these two number, right? 2 into 5 we want to multiply, that is why they have written 2. After we have simplified, here we have a common factor in the numerator and the denominator, can be
can get cancelled. So 2 by 5, it get cancelled by 5 times. So it is 5a. The denominator answer, they have given 5a. So look at the problem here, children. The denominator, if you have only one term, it's very simple. You take RF as the same number. That coefficient, if you have anything, no need to bother. You just ignore that. Consider only that number as the RF, multiply to the numerator and the denominator, and then you can proceed further. Okay. So now this is your second problem. So we have seen three examples for the denominator is a single number. Here we have the denominator is two number. Two number means in between we have plus symbol. What I told you, if it is two numbers, if you have plus or minus, the conjugate or the rationalizing factor, you have to take the opposite sign. So root 3 plus 2, what is the RF here? So the RF is nothing but it is 3 minus root 2. Root 3 minus root 2. So that's why they have chosen here root 3 minus root 2. That 3 root 3 minus root 2 is the conjugate of root 3 plus root 2. And they have multiplied in the numerator and the denominator, the factor. Okay. And here only we have to concentrate. We want to multiply the numerator and the denominator. That is the next step. Okay. So how to do? Here you have to see. That is very important. First we want to multiply these two. 1 into root 3 minus root 2. Whatever you are multiplying with 1, we will get the same number. That's why they have written the numerator as the same number. Now look at the denominator. We have root 3 plus root 2, root 3 minus root 2. Here you can apply the identity to solve further. Okay, so this number, it is in the form of a plus b into a minus b. So what is the identity? It says that a plus b into a minus b, it's nothing but a square minus b square, right? That's why they have written here this number, root 3 is a and root 2 is b. They have written here root 3 the whole square minus root 2 the whole square. And now we can square, in the sense we can twice multiply here also root 2 into root 2, right? Root 3 into root 3, already by square concept we can write this step, root 3 into root 3, root 2 into root 2. According to the square root concept, we can take one number outside. So the answer is here for 3 and here for 2. That's why they have written here 3 minus 2. 3 minus 2, it's 1. If you are dividing any number divided by 1, the same numerator is the answer. So they have given here it's root 3 minus root 2. So if you have the denominator is two numbers, now first you choose the conjugate, okay, the RF, that is important here. That is the first step. After choosing that, you have to multiply with the numerator and the denominator. That is very important. Next, multiply with the numerator and the denominator here. After you multiply these two and multiply these two, and denominator you can apply the identity to further solve. So root 3 the whole square, root 2 the whole square, or else instead of this you can cross out the square and root directly. You can move to this step also, root 3 minus root 2 divided by 3 minus 2, it is 1. So the answer is root 3 minus root 2. So this is the procedure if you have the denominator is two terms. Okay, remember this, children. Okay, let's see. I'll give you here some problem. Tell me what is the RF for the first problem, 4 by root 5. What is the RF for the first one? It is nothing but we have the denominator a single number, so the same root 5 is the RF. Okay, the second number, what is the RF? Root 3 only we have, so here also root 3. For the third problem, what is the RF? We have two numbers, 2 plus root 3, so the RF is 2 minus root 3. So further we can use the previous method, previous problem, what I solved like that. You can apply and solve this. You just take your rough note and you just try this problem how to solve. Then you can get a better idea how to solve and how to rationalize the denominator. Okay, children.